Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Today, we meet again for a Waalaxy demo. I'm going to give you a quick overview of the tool. I will show you the features and the global functioning. So, the first question is, what is Waalaxy? Waalaxy is an automation software. This is perfect if you have a significant volume of actions to perform, especially on LinkedIn, and you want to automate this task, including sending connection requests, follow-up messages, visits, as well as profile tracking. I'll put this in French for me. So the tool is available in 11 languages for the moment. It is an automation software in the form of a Chrome extension. So you'll have to use the Chrome browser to use it, and that's it. Let's move to the next step. So, how does Waalaxy work? The first step is to build a list of prospects. So we're going to segment our prospects by different criteria. It's up to you. And we'll organize them into lists. To create these lists and therefore import prospects into them, there are different ways to do it. You can either do it through an import via a LinkedIn search, an import via a CSV file, or also an import from groups or events to which you belong on LinkedIn. You can also import saved searches, as well as led lists if you use LinkedIn Premium Sales Navigator. So here, we're going to focus on the easiest way, and that is, in my opinion, the import via the LinkedIn search. So to create a lead sheet, we go directly on LinkedIn. Click where I just did, and type in the keywords about your leads. So let's imagine that we are currently looking for sales. We will also be able to granulate our search to better segment it. Let's imagine that we are looking for salespeople in Montpellier. So SDRs for sales development representatives. We're going to granularize our search using filters. And when we are satisfied with the results, and we want to interact with these people, we just need to import them into a list that corresponds. So either I have one that I've created beforehand into which I'll import prospects regularly. Otherwise, if it doesn't match any of the criteria, I can create one on the fly. So I will call it SDR Montpellier. I click on Create and I choose the number of leads to validate. Now I have 34 results, so the maximum number of leads to import is 34, and I click on Validate. So while my import is in progress, or once it's finished, I'll start building my campaign. So the campaign is simply the next step. I mean, it's simply a sequence in which your list of prospects will move, and the prospects within that list will have different actions that will be triggered. A picture speaks louder than 1,000 words. And so, by clicking here, I'm going to have access to the quick launch. So this represents the most popular and easiest to use campaigns. Otherwise, I click on Browse Sequences, and there I have access to all the sequences. So what I would recommend to do at first is to use the filters, the time to adapt to the tool. So you can, in quotes, put the criteria that you want to see in your campaign. So let's imagine a classic campaign. I want to get in touch with my prospect, so first I have to send him a connection request if we're not in the first degree. Then I want to send him a message, and I want an automatic follow-up. So two messages in total. So I'll be able to have campaigns that correspond to these criteria. Let's say I don't want there to be any profile visits. I can also exclude certain conditions, and it will only show me the campaigns that correspond to the criteria I have chosen. So we just need to see a little bit of the campaign according to our use case. So there, it's classic, invitation two messages, and click on select. Then, you just have to rename the campaign according to your choice. I advise you to rename it according to the list, or at least the profile of prospects you wish to contact. So here we are going to do SDR Montpellier, or else for example, SDR South, if I know that I will be able to add prospects a little later. For example, I manage the geographical area of the South, so I can add, for example, Lyon, Bordeaux, etc. I click on Next, and it asks me if I want to import from LinkedIn or from a list. I have already done my import, so it will be from a list. By clicking here, it also allows me to choose the list in question. So where I have just done the import, and this window is quite important because it also gives me access to another window. So if I choose to manually select my prospects, either I choose to select the whole list or I choose to select manually. If I choose to select manually, it gives me access to this window, and I have access to the auto import. What is auto import? It will simply allow you to automate actions, in particular the import into a list of my choice, but also the incorporation of this list into a campaign of my choice. So I have a lot of triggers, literally triggers, and for example, I can automate actions on people who send me a connection request. People who visit my profile, that's very interesting for recruiters, people who have a headhunter profile. People who have commented on a job. Very interesting to make a passive acquisition channel or simply organize a webinar to explain a little bit about it. Let's say I'm hosting a webinar and I don't want to make the link public. What can I do? You can make a post about it on LinkedIn. So, I'm going to do a webinar about X topic. If you're interested, comment my post. I imagine that you've already seen a lot of posts that look like this one. So all the people who are going to comment on my post to show their interest, I'm going to be able to automatically import them into the lists of my choice. So I can create one called Webinar X or Y. And so that will do two things. One, auto-segment the leads. That's kind of half my job as a marketer in the sense that the people that are going to interact with my webinar, at least with the post on LinkedIn, want to participate in the webinar logically. And on top of that, it's going to automatically integrate them into the campaign of my choice. In this case, we'll have an invitation two messages. But for example, I can just do one message or an invitation one message with the link and the details about the webinar. This is just a use case, a free example. It's up to you to do what you want. The post doesn't have to be yours to use this feature. Just click here and paste the URL of said post. You can choose whether it's retroactive or not, so only people who are going to comment or people who have already commented. So that's it on this point of the auto import. Then, hop. You just have to follow the steps that will be displayed, it's not very complicated. It asks me if I want to add content to my invitation, I'd rather not. It asks me the delay between the acceptance and the sending of the first message. Usually, by default, it's 1 day. So, once my prospect has accepted me, there will be a 1 day delay. Then, he will receive the first message which will be this one. It's up to me to enter the content of my message. I can use variables that will change depending on the person I am talking to. For example, I can use company variables that will change the name of the company to that of the prospect I am contacting. I can also use templates, so pre-written messages that I can reuse, of course. And once we are satisfied with our messages, we click on Validate, we choose the delay between the first message and the reminder, and then, we click on Next, we enter the contents of the second message. We click on Validate and we send the campaign. That's it for this point. There is also the possibility to do multi-channel with Waalaxy. That's where its strength lies in my opinion, and it's more of a cross-channel campaign. So we're not going to stuff our prospect with the same information, or at least the same information on two different channels. Instead, we'll try to vary, so we'll try to find an anchor point on one of the channels, usually LinkedIn. And if this channel fails, for example, my prospect does not accept my connection request or my prospect does not respond to me after a certain period of time, the follow-up is done on his email. Please note that Waalaxy has the ability to collect two types of emails. The email attached to your prospect's LinkedIn account, so whether it is visible or not, as long as you are connected to your prospect, you can use this email, thus attached to his LinkedIn account. Attention, important point, the majority of people who have an email attached to their LinkedIn account, it is a personal email, so in the context of recruitment or for B2C, it is interesting. On the other hand, for B2B, we prefer to avoid it, depending on our sector of activity. And so Waalaxy also has the ability to enrich business emails. So in this case, how do we do it? All you have to do is choose a campaign that matches and make sure that your campaign has an email finder step. So when you see this box there, it means that we will try to enrich the email of our prospect. So using Dropcontact, which is integrated directly into Waalaxy, there is no extra cost. As long as you have the business plan, you can use email enrichment. I'll come back to the plans and the difference between them a little bit later. But the most important thing is, if you want to contact your prospects only on their business email, it's better to use campaigns that have the email finder in them that comes in right before the email is sent. So we see that there is the email finder, we will come and use a credit, so you have 500 per month to enrich the professional email of our prospect. That's all there is to it. So there, in this campaign called Buzz Lightyear 2.0, so Buzz Lightyear, we start with a visit, we send a connection request, once my prospect has accepted the connection request, there is the delay of 1 day, or 0, you can choose, then, first message, follow-up message and if I still have no answer, the last follow-up is done on his email. Why do I say that the main strength of Waalaxy lies in this? It's simply that you can send a connection request, and even if this connection request doesn't lead to anything, so it's not accepted, normally, the adventure stops there on LinkedIn. We can no longer get in touch with our prospect unless we delete the connection request, wait a little while and send it again, hoping that this time it will be accepted. But then, even if my prospect doesn't accept my connection request, I can still come and enrich his professional email. So Dropcontact uses a semantic method, so we will take the first name, the last name and the company name, and it will try to guess the professional email address of your prospect. Once the email address has been found, if it has been found, then we will be able to contact our prospect anyway. So theoretically, Waalaxy always ensures that you have a way to contact your prospect, whether it's on their LinkedIn or their email. Here, once the campaign is launched, I'm going to be able to access my queue. So here I'm going to have the type of prospect, well, the type of action, sorry, the name of my prospect, the name of the campaign, and the estimated execution time. You should know that the execution time is semi-random to avoid sending an action every 2 minutes, which is more like a bot than a human being. The quotas are also there. So it's a point of differentiation between the plans. But it's mostly there to secure your LinkedIn account in the sense that if you send 400 actions, for example, 400 connection requests, 400 messages, 400 profile visits per day, that's an inhuman activity and your LinkedIn account can get restricted because LinkedIn thinks you're a bot. That's why the daily quotas were put in place by Waalaxy. It's just to kind of regulate the activity a little bit and extend it over a period of time. So when I have an active campaign, that campaign will draw on the resources needed. For example, I have a campaign that requests a connection message and I have 130 prospects. So I'll have 95 of them who will receive the connection request if they accept it directly and my deadline is 0 days. They will receive the message directly within 0 to 2 hours. All this to say that if my campaign has 130 prospects, 40 of them will be paused because I have more connection requests to send today, so my campaign will be paused. However, it will automatically resume, as soon as the quota has been updated. So the quotas are updated daily and this allows you to spread your activity over the week to avoid having too much activity at once, which can be suspicious and therefore restrict your account. A little explanation about quotas. So connection requests are to get in touch with someone, when you are in the second, third degree, in any case, when you are not connected to your prospect. You have to send a connection request or receive one from them first. Once it has been accepted, you are in the first degree and you can converse using messages. Messages can only be sent to people who are in the first degree with you. Profile visits allow you to appear more human, but it also allows you to update information about your prospect. If you have a list of prospects that is a little old and you haven't used it, I recommend that you have a profile visit step before you take action. That way, if your prospect, for example, has changed companies in the meantime, it's updated. And if you use a company variable, it will be the right one that is used. So message requests allow you to go bypass the first degree rule for contacting someone. So message requests are like the poor man's email. Message requests allow you to contact your prospects, regardless of whether or not they are connected to you, as long as they are in the same event group. So when you go to the same group or event as someone, instead of sending a connection request before it's accepted and then a message, I recommend getting in touch directly with the message request. The profile followings are for the influencer's profile, so you have to follow them first and it allows you to get them a little bit interested in the sense that when you're going to send them a connection request, it'll show that you're following them and so you're trying to get in connection, get in contact with them. The email finder is simply a business plan that allows you to use multi-channel campaigns and the email finder is directly embedded in it. It is Dropcontact that is Increment in Waalaxy and that will take care of the enrichment when you use campaigns that have an email finder step in it. A very important point to note is that with the email finder, you are only debited for the result and not for the action, so you are only debited when the email is found. This is a very important point. What is the team feature? It's simply for companies, if they want to get organized, if there are several of you using Waalaxy, I recommend you to organize yourselves in team. It allows you to generalize billing from a single account. It also allows you to go to your colleagues' accounts and interact with their profiles. And last but not least, it allows you to manage duplicates. So, how does the pricing work? You will have three types of monthly payments, so you will either pay monthly, quarterly, or annually. The more you progress in the annuality, the less expensive it is. So you will have three paid plans and one free plan, so the free plan allows you to use Waalaxy for life. However, you are limited to 15 actions of each type per day. So 15 connection requests, 15 messages, etc. The Pro plan gives you access to the cloud solution. So note that with the free plan, you have to keep a LinkedIn tab open to be able to use Waalaxy, especially when you have an active campaign, you have to have a LinkedIn tab open for the actions to be performed. With the other plans, this is not the case because there is the cloud solution that will allow you to, whether your computer is on or not, whether you have a LinkedIn tab or not, your actions will be sent in time. At the Pro level, the Pro plan allows you to organize yourself as a team. It also increases your quotas to 30 per day, so you can send 30 connection requests, 30 messages, etc. So the advanced plan will allow you to have the maximum quotas, so around 80 to 100 connection requests per day, 100 to 150 messages per day, etc. It also allows you to have CRM synchronization, so for the moment, only no CRM is natively integrated. Otherwise, for the others, for example HubSpot, Pipedrive, Salesforce, Zoho, and Google Sheet, if you use it as a CRM, you have to use Zapier. But here it is, so it allows you to have a CRM synchronization. It also gives you access to the auto-import functionality, so what I mentioned with the webinar in particular. And the business plan gives you access to all the features. Mainly, it's going to be multi-channel, so the possibility to use multi-channel campaigns, the ones I showed you earlier, like Buzz Lightyear. And so it includes the email finder, so the email enrichment. So there are three types of monthly, monthly, quarterly, or annual. There are a lot of other features to discover, including a lot of filters that will allow you to segment your prospects, to organize yourself and especially the tags that allow you to create subcategories. But I don't want the video to last too long, so I recommend testing the tool. You have a 1-week premium trial, so as a business plan, you can also use the multi-channel, test the enrichment and all the features for free, no need for a credit card or anything. You go to waalaxy.com, you download the tool or otherwise directly in the link in the description, and there you go. Hopefully this video was helpful to you. Like I said, test the tool, there is nothing better to see if it fits your use case. There are a lot of features I didn't show you otherwise the video will go on too long. That's it. I wish you a good evening, a good day and see you soon.
À bientôt.